WHNT News 19 at 5 starts now.
And thank you for joining us on WHNT News 19 at 5. Welcome in, everyone. I'm Greg Struge.
And I'm Siobhan Bryan. The number of COVID-19 cases is continuing to rise in Marshall County. It now ranks fourth in the state for the number of positive cases.
But many businesses in county and city offices are reopening under the governor's amended Safer at Home order. Memorial Day weekend also coming up, and the lakes and parks are expected to be very crowded as people get outdoors.
Absolutely. And WHNT News 19's Tiffany Lester joins us live from Marshall County to tell us what it's been like for one nurse practitioner who has treated more than two dozen COVID-19 patients. Tiffany?
A new Department of Homeland Security report says that Marshall County reported a new 217 positive coronavirus cases over the last 7 days. Now, that is a 517% spike over the previous 7 days. Now, the owner of Outside the Box Healthcare and nurse practitioner Robin Scott says she's treated 30 to 35 of those infected patients. Now, there has been a lot of testing at different places here in the county, and some say that that high number of testing is why our numbers is so high. But Scott says she thinks Marshall County is a hotspot for a couple of different reasons. One, the large industries here, including multiple poultry plants. She says many workers are most likely scared to even be tested because they can't afford that to be on unpaid leave if they do test positive. People also aren't wearing masks like they have been recommended to. She tells me that the novel coronavirus is spread through saliva droplets and can actually linger in the air after someone coughs, sneezes, or even talks. So even if you are 6 feet apart, if you walk right behind someone and neither of you are wearing a mask, it could get into your system. Scott tells me most of her patients that tested positive were also completely asymptomatic. No fever, cough, or anything.
I'd say the majority of the did not develop into a moderate disease, but I've got a couple that got very ill. To have a patient look at you and say, am I going to make it through this? And you can't really answer for sure if they're going to or not is a scary thing.
Says while we do have to get back to work to keep the economy alive, she calls temperature checks a joke. She says she thinks those are done out of good faith, but that the majority of her patients did not have a fever. Others only had a fever of 99 degrees, which by the time you have the mild fever like that, you've already been transmitting the virus for several days. Scott also tells me that even if a patient does get COVID-19 and recovers, they could suffer from lifelong effects like lung and heart issues. Reporting in Marshall County, Tiffany Lester, WHNT News 19.
All right, thanks, Tiffany. Let's get a check of the forecast with Chief Meteorologist Jason Simpson.
Feels like April today, but it's mid-May. The heat hasn't really set in yet, but within the next 7 days, you're going to notice it. It's 74 in the Huntsville area at the moment. Owens Crossroads is at 73. Crossville's at 71, and Albertville is at 70. Madison's in the mid-70s. Athens is only at 72. And in the Shoals, it's been a little warmer around Muscle Shoals and Tuscumbia today. Mid-70s right now, but across the river, St. Florine is only at 69. The showers have been well northeast of Huntsville for most of the day. Lincoln, Franklin, Jackson, DeKalb, and then a little bit of Marshall County have gotten some light rain here and there. And it's all because of this same feature that we've been talking about all week, the upper low, but it moves away from us in coming days and allows the heat and humidity to build in again. We'll have just enough moisture for some isolated showers tomorrow, but then watch this. Out of the northwest, here comes a big cluster of rain and thunderstorms Friday morning right along this boundary. It's a warm front. The warm fronts separate this time of year, relatively warm air from the soupy, the muggy. And once that muggy air takes over for the Memorial Day weekend, it's going to feel a whole lot more uncomfortable around here in that time frame. We're down to 69 by 7, 66 at 8 o'clock. You got to walk Marley this evening. You should be rain free in most spots. We'll talk about rain chances up and down through the next 7 days coming up.
All right, thank you, sir. Today, Richard Wayne Penniman, also known to many as Little Richard, was laid to rest at Oakwood University. WHNT News 19 has team coverage from when he was escorted to Oakwood, his celebration of life, fans' reaction to his passing, and we talked to musicians who worked with the legend in the Shoals.
Absolutely, and WHNT News 19's Ashton Hiram begins our team coverage as she rode along with law enforcement who escorted his funeral procession.
They said they got contact with the family. They're going to have them lined up in the median south of Rastaway.
discharge. I'm at the construction zone on Highway 53.
Got a host of traffic held up, but it's northbound. It's not going to interfere with us coming south. Just heads up.
10-4, we're going to bump it up to right at 45.
Little Richard, a pioneering performer who helped rhythm and blues become rock and roll.
And he was laid to rest right here in Huntsville at Oakwood Memorial Gardens. That's on campus at Oakwood University. WHNT News 19's Lauren Hartson was there for the service and joins us now live. Lauren.
That's right. Little Richard was the self-proclaimed architect of rock and roll. But after speaking with so many of his friends and family today, he wasn't the only one that thought that.
He restored.
May 9th, 2020.
My soul.
The world lost a renowned artist referred to as one of the founding fathers of rock and roll, Little Richard, to cancer. Some say it's the day the music died.
He actually brought color and life to music, not just rock and roll, but to music, to the arts.
Richard Penniman was a special human being. His musical talent, sense of style, and charisma made him one of the most enduring cultural icons the world has ever known.
Family, friends, and band members came together to not only mourn his death, but celebrate his life. They say he was an inspiration.
We would watch his move and we would do like Little Richard.
Every time and every moment we were with him, it was history. It was actually living history. It was historic.
The singer attended Oakwood University in Huntsville, then known as Oakwood College. And May 20th, 2020, he was laid to rest at the very place he studied theology at the height of his career.
June of 1978, listening to Richard's testimony about loving God and calling men and women to repentance.
He became a living testimony of how God can U-turn a man's life.
This is my story.
So the family hopes that the public will see Richard as more than a rock icon and a world-renowned entertainer. They hope that people will see Richard as a human being.
He's a spark that's left this earth, and it will be no other spark like it.
But even though Little Richard has passed,
rock and roll is alive forever. Love you.
And it's true that Little Richard's legacy will live on. And as for his truest friends, family, and fans, they will never forget the man who transformed rock and roll. Live in Huntsville, Lauren Harkson, WHNT News 19.
All right, thank you, Lauren. Now, fans around the world, needless to say, saddened at the news of Little Richard's passing. Family held that private memorial service this morning, but his most loyal fans didn't want to miss out. About 150 family members and close friends said their goodbyes to the rock and roll icon, but only a handful of fans watched the memorial service from a distance. Jacqueline Booker says she's always been a fan of Little Richard. For many years, she sang and danced to his biggest hits.
And I followed his career from the time I was a teenager. And I remember him coming on television and the wild antics and the fabulosity of the way that he dressed and his overall workmanship on the stage.
Booker says she felt like she had a chance to say goodbye at Little Richard's homecoming this morning, even though she watched him rest in peace from afar.
And after Little Richard's passing, many musicians and artists who worked with him looked back on the history that they shared. WHNT News 19's Jeremy Jackson spoke with three of them, has more from Colbert County.
Little Richard's career spanned nearly 70 years, and in that time, he made a lasting impact on everyone he met, including artists right here in the Shoals. In the early 70s, Little Richard recorded the album The Real Thing at Fame Studios in Muscle Shoals. It was the only album the artist recorded in the Shoals. Local guitarist Travis Womack played on the album and eventually joined Little Richard's band.
You know, we did shows with Richard. He never had a set list. We never knew what he was going to do. But he would go out there, and before he even sang a song, he had the crowd right there in the palm of his hand.
Guitarist Kelvin Holly says Richard was as much a businessman as he was an entertainer. He had a strict pay-before-play policy.
I can remember several shows of sitting backstage in the dressing room, and you could hear the crowd getting unruly because Richard hadn't come out because he hadn't gotten paid.
Tanya Holly, Kelvin's wife and owner of Cypress Moon Studios in Sheffield, booked Richard for the premiere of her film, When I Find the Ocean, which premiered in 2006 at the Marriott Shoals Conference Center.
I couldn't think of anybody else I would rather have. He'd always been real supportive of me wanting to be a director. I'd been in the film business for a long time, and so he always told me he was praying for me. And so I had him come in. We paid him. And up front, like you're supposed to, and Little Richard and his huge band and entourage came in and played an incredible night for the Shoals area.
Little Richard, the innovator, the originator, the architect of rock and roll, was laid to rest this morning in Huntsville at Oakwood University Memorial Gardens. In Muscle Shoals, Jeremy Jackson, WHNT News 19.
And the musicians who perform with Little Richard, like those that you just saw, they say his passing marks the end of an era.
WHNT News 19's coverage doesn't stop on air. Our digital team has activated a live blog on the celebration of life of Little Richard on WHNT.com. You can find the blog by just searching Little Richard. Along with the live blog, you can also find all of our coverage honoring the life and legacy of the rock and roll legend.
It's been pleasant lately, but you know that summertime heat's coming soon, and Jason tells us when to expect hotter weather coming up. Before we go to break, we are so close to getting to $100,000 for our Fill the Food Bank drive for the Food Bank of North Alabama. And thanks to you, more than 1,200 donors have helped us get almost 98 grand. Keep those donations coming and help us provide 700,000 meals for the Tennessee Valley. The easiest way to donate is text HUNGER to 256-559-3299. You'll be sent a direct link to donate to the Food Bank of North Alabama. We're also going to have other options on WHNT.com, and this drive runs through June 1. Thank you for watching WHNT News 19 at 5. We'll be right back.
Our doors are open at Landers McClarty Nissan. Pre-owned demand has dropped. Rather than lose money at auction, we're selling below current market price.